How does a wild boar come into play for a show about alligator hunting? Well, stick with me. Last week, you may recall that I slocked this hog. I'm gathering bait. Bait for a swamp monster. So now it's time to hang the boar at the edge of the swamp, for there's monsters out there waiting to take my bait. From the very beginning, man has been a hunter. I too am a hunter, and I have hunted all my life. I gather flesh and bones, as my forefathers once had. A journey of pursuing the great beast of the earth. Even so, the chase is hard, for my quarry is keen to the ways of man, and I must hide and wait. Taking life and giving back. It's the cycle of life. This is a hunter's journey, a relentless pursuit.
Got him! Bullseye!
You're looking here at the typical swamp in Florida, full of these cypress trees, lots of bird feathers because they roost in the cypress at nights, and the occasional bird comes down for a drink and the gators kill them. But there's miles upon miles of this kind of habitat. And I'm looking on the banks. You try to find where they slide. That's where they crawl up and down on the bank, and there's none here, but I saw one when I was walking in. They slide up and down. Here's one here. It's not used a lot, but it's definitely an alligator slide. You can see here. So you don't see any alligators here because they still know I'm here. When I walked in, I saw one go down and I heard one flop off the bank because they'll sun themselves in the middle of the day. But I know there's multiple alligators in here because of the trail cam pictures I've got. I set my trail cam up here, picked out a good location, and when I pulled the covert camera, I was skeptical anyway about if it was even possible to spear an alligator from a tree stand. But when I pulled the covert, I about freaked out. I could not believe what has happened. But that's what happens when you spear or when you bait alligators for 3 or 4 days in a row with rotten bait, and then we've added my own hog kill to the pile. But every morning you come back and every scrap is gone. So this is what we found when we looked at the covert, and it was astonishing.
More than 1 million gators live in the swamps of Florida. And in remote sections, their numbers burgeon. When water levels are low, like they are today, they gather in deep, secluded swamps. And it's here that we begin our hunt for a giant. You can reach out to Clint Sidney or I on Instagram. Or go to slockmaster.com. There you can find us on Instagram, Facebook, or watch all our YouTube videos. We even got some cool merchandise, especially if you'd like a spear or blowgun. Meanwhile, we'll look for you in the timber. After seeing who was hitting my bait, I tied my boar to the edge of the swamp, set a muzzy stand, grabbed my spear, and began another long wait. Today it's cool, and the gators are reluctant to come to my bait, but the mosquitoes are all in.
Monsoons all day long. It's been pouring down rain. There's a big one, Liz, right there. I think that's our boy. He stuck his nose out earlier. I can see a little one way off in the distance through the brush.
At last, an 8-footer has arrived. He's big, but I'm looking for bigger. The gator begins to feed, which attracts others. Big Louie has arrived. He's just out of spear range. But meanwhile, the others begin to forage on the bait. The thrashing echoes throughout the forest canopy. And like a dinner bell, it attracts more. I can see gators stirring in every direction. Finally, the big gator has had enough. He's coming in for his share. Others join in, and the frenzy begins. Now's my chance. I'm taking the throw. I've missed a giant. The gators have no clue what's happened, and they're already beginning to come back to the bait. But I've left my second spear on the ground for a backup. I'm Tim Wells. What a bonehead. And I use Morel targets, Carbon Express arrows. I buy from Bass Pro and use cold steel knives. I kill animals with Grim Reapers. Advanced taxidermy brings them to life. I use Muzzy for big fish and wear mossy oak camo. My Oneida bow goes with me in an SKB case. I shoot Umarex air guns and fish from tracker boats. Fox Pro is my go-to call. And I drive a Ford truck, because Ford trucks are tough. So, this is a really fancy machine shed here.
Yeah.
Kelvin was in charge of this. Look at the size of that gig over there. Kelvin, what's that gig for you use behind you there? That fascinates me.
Tilapia, hey.
You can gig tilapia with that giant thing?
This here is a gator guy that's famous. His name's on it.
Manny Clay.
Manny?
You know Manny.
Long-haired boy.
Manny made that?
Yeah, he makes them, sells them, $1,200 a piece.
No kidding. Manny, you're going to put me out of business.
Yep.
Manny got bit by a rattlesnake down with my brother Buck.
Yeah, and a hog cut him up too.
Yeah, he's probably been through a lot of things in his life.
We're here.
No. I'll get one directly from the man. That's a pretty nice souvenir you got
he
there.
He makes all kind of stuff. I mean, all kind of big old.
So, anyway, I dropped by here to show the some of my friends that have spears out there that buy them from me. Tim said he could make them straight again. Yes. And look how straight they are now. They're good to go, ready to throw again. A little bit of
that
tweak to them.
Call on how much time you want to spend on it.
And you can see they're the same ones because there's parts of them missing and stuff. But in terms of the spear, how'd you get them straight, man?
Just put a vice grip on it so it don't spin. But just find you something that's real close together and it's round so it don't mess it up. But you just stick it in there and look down it, and then bend it like that. You bend it back straight.
You just went inch by inch.
Yep. You just find which way, look down it, where it needs to be bent, and start right there and bend it down.
The vice grips are the key, though, so you got a handle.
So it doesn't spin, or else it'll spin on you.
Wow. Thank you, guys. Mm-hmm. You know, after I bent those, I gave them to Danny. I should have kept them, huh?
Yeah.
Well, you can keep them, Danny. Who's your friend there behind you? He's been hanging out with us all week.
That's old Cass right there. He's a good puppy dog. What's up, Cass? Say hi to the camera. He thinks he's a human.
Well, Kelvin said he's a coward.
And I think he's getting heartworms.
He's the coward of the county.
Look here. This bungee cord.
Yes, sir.
You put your line there on the swivel, tie this to the tree, and then that'll take it.
Right. Oh. That's a great idea.
You just tie this here to the tree and tie the swivel on it where it kinked after a while.
Hey, that's beautiful.
When it comes tight, see, look, it's going to be beautiful.
So we're learning as we go. We got all kind of methods here to keep you guys, when you hook up with a 1,000-pound alligator, if you're a crocodile over there in Africa, or maybe a 500-pound alligator, there's quite a bit of force behind that baby, ain't there? Yes, and you want it so when he hits the end of the line, he didn't pull your spear out, which we haven't had happen, but it could happen. So this is the best way to keep that from happening. There we go.
That night, the gators ate most of the bait, so I returned with more, including the dead rooster that I've rigged up to flop in the water. At high noon, the same giant has showed up, but he's swimming just out of range. So I pulled the string, flopping my rooster in the water, just to see what the gator would do. And to my surprise, Big Louie turned and headed for the bait. He's 15 yards out. I need the gator to grab the bait, for when he does, he'll close his eyes. At that point, he won't see the throw coming. The Seahawk has hit the gator. There's no time. I'm climbing down now to try and slock him again. I tried to pull the beast ashore, but with all my might, he was just too powerful. So I'm going in after him. I slocked him again. Do you own a blowgun or spear? Well, slockmaster.com is where they're sold. We've got the best razor darts, blowguns, fishhawks, and spears right here at slockmaster.com. They're just too much fun. Pick off a squirrel or rabbit while you're waiting on a deer, and bring home some hassan pepper for dinner. By golly, at slockmaster.com, we sell the perfect gift. So check us out at slockmaster.com.
I'm having the time of my life. Give me a blowgun and send me in the woods and
I'm as happy as a little kid in a candy store. Eventually, the spears have done the job, but I'm not taking any chances. I think I'll use a little cold steel insurance before dragging this monster ashore.
Look at that. That's a big old reptile hand.
Oh yeah. Not even dull. I could kill another one with it. Now if one don't swim up behind me and bite me on the ass, it's gonna be a pretty successful morning.
Oh my gosh, he's a monster. So, the gator that ate the dogs and has a tendency to eat things it's not supposed to, like baby cows, is probably bigger than this one. The test of my new spear, the Seahawk, is more than adequate. I think the first spear would have got him, but the second one probably did the number. Danny set my muddy tree stand just perfect. I was hiding behind that tree, three trees, and so I hid my silhouette. And when he saw that chicken bouncing, he comes screeching in there right at him. He put on the brakes right before he got to him, but eventually he said, nope, chicken dinner. I don't blame him either, because chicken's one of my favorite. But this ain't no KFC when you show up here, boys.
We got it done. We got it done.
Oh my gosh.
Tim's put in some hard hours in this tree up here, but.
You know that adrenaline rush you get after, right before you go to the football game, before you score, or you make that last shot and the crowd goes crazy, you know? When I finally anchored that dude with that second spear, man, I felt that surge again.
Hey, that's what every hunter thrives for right
now,
there, baby.
And now I'm like, oh man, I just need a drink. Well, I know we got a lot of work to do, but hey, buddy, thanks a lot.
We're gonna go get this gator skin out. Okay. He's gonna be some good eating.
Hey, the dead chicken idea worked, buddy. Good idea.
Sometimes you have to sacrifice to for reward, but we got it.
Oh man, look at that. Wow, fantastic. Look here, guys. This is the other spear. It came all the way through my gator. Now, with any other traditional spear, then you got a dilemma when you kill an animal. But with mine, and there's a keeper in there, so it don't, it was still tight. They don't come unscrewed, and the gator's not going to lose, you're not going to lose your spear or your shark. You won't lose your shark, whatever, or a buffalo carp. But anyway, barring the line didn't break, he wouldn't have got off. Although I was freaking out because I thought he might. I climbed down out of that tree, and I probably shouldn't have went in the water after him, but I didn't want that bad boy getting away, and he was thrashing around out there. I mean, water was splashing everywhere, Danny. It was crazy, bud.
That's awesome, man.
And I went out there, and I got a double slock on my gator. I got my money's worth today, buddy.
Yes, sir. All right.
So I'll just pull this spear right out of him now. That's, one of the claims that I have is my spears are made to bend when they go through an animal, so they flex. And, but this is one wicked bend. I don't know if I'll be able to straighten this bad boy back out, but most of the time you can just straighten him back out. This is a...
That's a banana.
Yeah, this is for throwing around cypress trees. If you got one around the corner, you just flip it around the corner. It's kind of the boomerang spear effect, but this one's gonna go on my wall. Next to Big Louie's hide. I just put it on my wall with a picture of me and Danny holding my alligator. And if I live another 30 years, it'll be a real nice thing to look at when I'm out in the man cave sipping a cup of coffee every morning.